Welcome back, everybody. Here with some really fun and easy no-sew Halloween costumes that are perfect for the little ones or the big ones in your life. Whoever can fit in them is going to wear them.
What
is Orly?
Yes.
I love this idea, Orly.
How cute are those photos? I know. I mean, this costume idea, what I love about it so much is the idea that it's basically one very simple pattern that can be changed just slightly to give you all sorts of different costumes. You do not need to sew this at all, and it comes together in minutes. Like literally
10 minutes.
Yes, this is so simple. And obviously you can see it works for all ages. I mean, we have kids, we have really cute kids here on set wearing them from
that's
ages
adorable.
Like 5 all the way up to 12. But you know, I mean, that strawberry could be a t-shirt for us.
100%.
You know, it's like, it's so cute, it's so easy.
One of our producers, Talene, was wearing the pizza just yesterday and this avocado over here, I mean, come
how
on.
How fun.
Any of us could fit in this.
100%.
I love this. All right, I'm excited. How do we do this?
All right, so the first thing that you need is your felt. So I want to show you guys how to make the strawberry. So what you want to do with your felt is, you can see this is not quite the normal width because I've already made one strawberry out of it, but I just want to show you, we have it folded just in half. Now, this is the front and this is the back.
That's it.
Right? Because this is going to go on us like this.
Here. Like a poncho.
Exactly. So what we need to do is to create a neck hole.
All right.
Okay, so to do that, you take it already folded in half and fold it in half again. Okay? So this is the exact way you would do it for every single one of these costumes. So now that we have it in half, I want to create a neck hole.
Okay.
There's a few ways you can do that. One really easy one is to grab a t-shirt from your kid's closet, something that's not super stretch because you don't want to rip, you don't want to stretch this out too much, and lay it on top of your felt as a guide. If not, you can just measure it. I've kind of measured it, and so I'm going to cut. You can see I gave myself a little chalk point right there. So I'm going to come down just barely about 1 inch and go up to 0, meaning back up to nothing.
Okay.
Like that, right? So now if I open this, you can see that's my little
neck. That's perfect.
Okay. So that's it. I mean, this is like so simple. I can't even handle it. Okay. Fold it back in half. Now you want to create your shape. This is where the slight change happens depending on what you're making. Pizza, you're making it a triangle. Strawberry, it's like a rounded triangle.
Okay.
The avocado, it's bigger at the base and then comes in.
Okay. Right?
So this is just the shape part. Now to create my strawberry, I've given myself measurements. This is approximately 18 inches down. I've just put a little chalk, and then over here, I went over about 12 inches.
And is that because you measured Blake or Connor?
Yeah, you just work off the dimensions that you're working
with.
So now, to create a strawberry, it's not a sharp point, it's kind of a rounded point. So I'm just gonna kind of come like this, and I'm gonna eyeball it, but you could absolutely use a paper pattern if you wanted to. If you're worried about eyeballing it, go for a paper pattern, make the shape first, and then you lay it on top of your felt.
Okay.
So look, now I'm kind of coming back up and around because that's the shape that we normally get with a strawberry.
There you go.
Okay.
I can't even believe I'm watching this.
That's the strawberry.
There's your strawberry.
That's
and then you just put the seeds and the accoutrements.
Now we're
gonna
do all the details. So now when you're making something, you can see on the strawberry, obviously it has the little leaves that the strawberry has. So what you wanna make sure that you do is create a neck hole that's similar to that.
Okay.
So again, it's always easier folded in half. So I'm gonna fold my strawberry back in half because I want it to give me a guide. I'm gonna take my green felt now and I'm gonna fold that in half.
And then put it up against it.
Yeah, and now you lay this on top.
And you cut around
it. And you see the little guide, right? So now you can see the perfect guide. I'm just gonna cut this.
I can't even believe how easy this is.
This is going to now be identical in shape.
Oh my goodness.
Now, I don't need all this excess, so I'm gonna cut off a little bit here, and I just wanna show you roughly how you create the little
pointy things.
Cuts. So this is our shoulder, right? Because this is our neck, so this is our shoulder.
Yes.
So now you wanna go like this. You want like a nice little point. Now go down, now come back up.
Just back and forth until we
and
get
you just
this.
Keep creating like this.
So then we glue
and you
this
just
on.
You glue it on and you just wanna end up in the middle. So see right here, this is going to be our center. So try to end like that.
And down in a point.
And down because that will be your middle. So here it looks just like this. See how we've got a nice big one right in the center there?
Okay.
That's how you do that. Now.
And then we glue it?
You glue it on. So this will go right here in the front, and because it's perfectly fit, it's gonna lay like that. And now we just lay these guys on. You wanna do them with the little curly parts, the round part up. Always start in your middle, so you're centered in the middle, and then work your way out.
And you would do the same sort of technique with the pizza.
With everything.
And with the avocado.
Exactly.
Would you just wear it as a poncho, or would you make armholes?
So you don't actually need armholes because the whole side is open, but what you could do is you could do something like this, where you just make a simple strap that you could attach here to here if it's flapping open or it's really windy. You would just do like that little flap right there. Let me angle it more.
I mean, I cannot believe how cute this is.
It's so simple. I mean, it really is. Like, I wonder if this...
And I love that this is homemade.
It's so homemade. This was not planned.
Let me see. You have to put this on.
I mean, it works for all ages, as you can see. And you could even leave the pit open and put your candy inside.
Could you die? You also look like a safety patrol from elementary school. I love this.
I'm coming for you.
She's also going to help everyone cross the street, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much, Orly. This is adorable. For full instructions, all you have to do is head on over to HallmarkChannel.com.